Oh, so am I audible? Yeah. Am I audible? Give me some comment on the chat box, because I have some network issue fluctuation going on. Okay. Thank you, Bhumika. Good evening. So I'm Sonika Solomon. I am a digital marketing associate working in Aritech, and we are a small family working as a software company, and which is known as Aritech. It's a database company. So yeah, I welcome you all, and I'm seeing some old names again here, and thank you for coming again in our webinar and listening to us. Thank you. And today's topic is content strategy that can drive your organic leads to your blog, to your website. So organic leads, everybody wants it. We all know that leads are so important for the sale and to close the deal, how much efforts we all put in. But the thing is, how to generate it, how to generate just putting a campaign, putting an advertisement on the Facebook and Google Ads is it's a part of the marketing. But how to organically generate it for over years and building a loyal brand in front of audience. So we will be talking about that and how to build a reputation in front of your audience, so that whenever they see your content in their feeds, in their emails and in their newsletters, they should be taking action. They should be taking whatever CTA you are giving to them, they should perform that CTA, and you should be getting that result for your work, what you're doing. So not just about how to write a content, we will be talking about how to do the marketing of it. So today's a meeting, which will be a speaker was Ankit Prakash, who is the co-founder of Aritech, but due to some emergency, he is not here. But today I'm so happy to introduce new member. She is our content writer, content writing manager, content marketing manager. She is, and her name is Riya Biswas. She's from Kolkata, and it's really a pleasure to work with her. And she is really a talented girl, and she knows what she is doing in content, how she is writing, and she will be telling us how to generate organic leads through it and how to use it optimally. Over to you, Riya. I'm making you the host so that you can share your screen. Just a minute. I can see. Okay, you are the host right now.
Yeah. Thank you, Sonika, for introducing me. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Yeah, so today we are going to talk about content marketing, which is going to generate a lead. So let me start my PPT.
Sure.
Content marketing strategies that drive organic leads. What is content marketing? Content marketing is a process of planning, creating, distributing, publishing relevant and valuable content to grab the attention of the audience on multiple social media platforms. Just a second. Different companies, whether it is B2C companies, all have their own set of target audiences. So basically content marketing improves the brand awareness, engage prospects and connect with your target audience members and boost the sales. So consistency in content is very important to bring long-term success in content marketing. Why is content marketing important? We all know that outbound marketing is much more costlier than in marketing, and content has always been the king of all companies. So you can connect with different target audiences on different platforms through content. How you will generate and how you will improve, if you are writing a good content, then you can improve the brand's reputation and you can build a trust for your brand. How you will generate qualified leads to your company? It's very important for generating qualified leads. You should invest on search engine optimization. Search engine optimization helps bring organic lead generation strategies and attract valuable traffic. For smart content marketers, they generally segment the audiences on their product need. How you will build long bond with your customers? If you write good content, then slowly you will build large followers and develop stronger bonding with your customers. Steps to build an effective content strategy. First, you need to understand your company's vision and your brand story. Need to understand who is your target audience, what do your target customers want to know, what challenges or pain points are keeping them up at night. After knowing all these things, then you can make an outline of the mission. Then how you will prepare specific and measurable KPIs. First, if you want to achieve a certain goal for your brand, you need to be specific and measurable, and you can set up key performance indicators for your content marketing strategy. How to determine different types of content? So for every month you can evaluate your content. And you can evaluate your content through different tools, using different tools like Buzumo, and there are many other Google Trends. There are many other tools are there. You can evaluate your content. And after evaluating your content, you can plan for the next month as well as for the next quarter also, based on the performance. And you can check out on which content, which type of content is working. If blogs are working more, then you can focus more on blogs. If social media posts are working more, then you can focus on social media posts. So based on that, you can prepare different types of content. If you have a team, then you can take the help of your team to brainstorm the content ideas. And based on the content ideas, you can prepare content calendar on different, like you can use different tools for creating content calendar like Trello, Evernote, and Google content calendar also you can use for preparing content calendar. Then you can analyze which channel is working best for your product. Based on analysis, you can focus on those channels and you can post more on those channels to bring organic traffic. How data-driven content technique you can boost your ranking? So for creating actionable content, certain things you should keep in your mind. First, why are you creating this content? What market does it appeal to? What purpose will it serve to the audiences? Then if you are not writing blogs for your website, then you should start writing blogs, because blogs nowadays blogs bring much more traffic than other social media platforms. So the survey, if you are writing 16 blogs per month, then it's it will bring much more traffic to your website, and then you can generate lead magnet content. According to Google, ranking factors for any top ranking factors are content and link. What are the other types of link magnet content? Ebooks, videos, case studies, and videos. Then it's very, very important to craft attractive headline. If you can publicity among your customers with your headline, then half of your work is done. Then you can, nowadays your content is working quite well than text content, so you can focus more on video for your websites, for your posts, platforms. You can focus more on video content. You can, when you are writing any content, you can improvise your content with certain tools like Grammarly, Hemingway. You can use those tools to improvise your content. What are the methods to generate organic leads with marketing? You can, as I said, if you are not writing blog website, start writing blogs, because blogs help to bring good traffic to your website. From blogs you can create a blog post for your social media channels. So these things will help to bring traffic to your website, your digital platforms, as well as it will bring new leads. Simultaneously, you can work blogging. It's very important. Guest blogging is also very important, and you should be updating your landing pages. Nowadays, you put quizzes also, like you can conduct polls for your channels, and survey is the best thing which I have experienced from my past professional, like whatever content I have written. I have experienced that if you are conducting surveys, it helps you to understand what type of content your target audiences want. Then if you are thinking to write any blog, you need to understand the keywords. You need to research on the keywords. So you can use some tools for the keyword, like Keywords Everywhere, Google Keyword Planner, Moz Keyword Explorer, and more keyword tools are there. You can research on those, and after researching on the keywords, then only you can start writing blogs. And now for like mainly B2B companies, LinkedIn is the best profile. LinkedIn helps to bring much more leads than other channels. So you should focus on creating high quality content for LinkedIn. What are the fundamentals of content marketing? As I told you that you should understand your business objective, vision, what they are looking for, what is their goal. So accordingly, you can prepare your content calendar, your brand, what your brand demands, and in the like market, where your brand is positioning. Accordingly, you can prepare the messaging also. So if you have two types of product, one is for sensitivity and one is for sensitivity as well as tooth pain, then based on the if you understand your customer's pain point, then you can easily create content based on the pain point. You can create solutions. If you create solutions then those content are really helpful for your customers. In the previous slides, I told you that you need to analyze the channels, which are the channels which are working well for your brand. Accordingly, you can keep posting content on those channels. Like, for example, all channels for your brand, it will never, like, all channels will never work for your brand. If LinkedIn is working, Facebook is working, maybe Instagram will not bring that much traffic. So you can focus on the effective channels for your brand. Then copywriting guidelines during COVID-19. Now, you, according to the current scenario, you should communicate very sensitively with your customers. So you can avoid insensitive words and you can try to, you can ask your customers over call that how is their situation, and you can communicate accordingly with your customers. You need to be very accurate with your customers. Like, you need to be accurate with the data to prove your credibility in front of your customers. Now, at this current scenario, you can ease up with the offers. Like, you can give, you can increase the discounts, and you can give more offers to your customers so that they can come to your platform, they can come to your company for buying any goods. Don't lose the track, because don't think that after certain months the thing everything will be normal and things will be on track. So don't delete your old plans. Keep it with you so that you can use it in the upcoming months when the things will be normal. You can use those plans for upcoming months. Content marketing strategy at this current scenario. If you are focusing on certain channels, social media channels, suppose only if you are focusing only on Facebook or and Twitter, you should start focusing on other channels also, like YouTube, LinkedIn, Instagram, and other Pinterest, other channels also. You can partner with some trusted sources, and you can refine if you have already created. You have to refine those content plan so that you can build new content based on the current scenario. Try to show some empathy through webinars to your audiences, so that they can relate and they can feel like they can feel that you are there for them. Loyalty thing will be there. According to the statistics, 93% of marketers think that video is much more effective than text for lead generation. And as I told you that inbound marketing is much more cheaper than traditional marketing, outbound marketing, and it brings much more leads also than traditional marketing. 64% marketers invest their time mainly in search engine optimization. And 76% marketers are dependent more on organic traffic for proper engagement. What will be the impact of COVID-19 after after a few months? What will be the impact of COVID-19 on your business? Definitely, you will face new challenges. You have to revise your priorities based on the scenario. And right now, you can't assume what will happen after a few months. So you can, based on the scenario, what will be there after a few months, you can prioritize your content, and you have to think on new offers. right now you can't plan on the new offers. Concentrate or like you can concentrate on customers' demand. After this lockdown, maybe your products' demand will be high. So you during that time you have to focus based on the scenario. There are certain brands which are using content quite well at this pandemic current scenario, like DoubleTree, Nike, Domino's, Walmart, Coca-Cola. Because basically now, like outbound marketing has completely come to a standstill. So most of the brands are focusing more on inbound marketing. At the end, why Aritik is right platform for your business? Definitely, it's a full stack marketing automation platform. So it will help you to create campaigns, marketing campaigns, and build relevant workflows across all the channels, social media channels. It will help you to nurture potential leads through various automation platforms, and it will definitely help you to optimize the campaign and bring new leads for your channel and for your brands. Thank you. Now question and answer session started.
Thank you, Ria. Thank you so much. You have to give me the host. You have to give me the host authority because I'm not able to start my video after before that.
Okay.
Yeah. You have to stop your screen sharing and then.
You can now you can share your screen.
No, you have to go to the panelist option and then give me the host, right? Make me the host.
Wait.
It's okay, no. And we can have a quick Q&A session because you will be the right person to answer all the Q&As of audience attendees you're having. So you can put on your videos and we can answer it. Is that fine, Ria?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So thank you, Ria, for this informative PPT, and thank you for sharing all the good important information where we can what we can share, what type of content we can share in the website, and how to attract the quality leads, the type of audience we want for our website, how to attract it. You have given us good knowledge about it. So it's a Q&A session. If you guys are having anything regarding the strategies and how to do it, and how, any ideas of your or any feedback, you are welcome to ask anything.
Hello.
So one of the attendees asked that how to generate B2B content. Because the genre of B2B and B2C is different. How to do it for B2B businesses and how to use it in a Quora like platform in LinkedIn?
Pardon? Repeat the question.
How to use your B2B content in LinkedIn and Quora? How to use it? How to strategize it?
How to strategize for LinkedIn and Quora, right? Yeah, in LinkedIn, mainly what I have found that storytelling helps a lot. Storytelling content works a lot nowadays in LinkedIn. And Quora, yeah, you have to be very specific with the answer in Quora. So, and in LinkedIn, you can, if you have written blogs on your website, then you can generate a blog post from those blogs, and you can post it on LinkedIn. But mainly storytelling content works good in LinkedIn.
Mm-hmm. Storytelling?
Yeah.
In what platform?
LinkedIn.
LinkedIn, okay. Yeah, Gayatri is asking, if we are focusing on a co-working space, then how we can market the content wisely to get more leads? What kind of platform? Means in a co-working space, if you are focusing off like a workspace or like that, sharing offices. So what kind of content we should generate for them? A WeWork kind of platform.
Pardon?
If we are creating, I think so your network is unstable. If we are creating a content for WeWork or some co-working space, okay. So how to create content for that kind of business?
Okay. So you have to understand what is their requirement. So based on that, I think you have to create content.
Mm-hmm. So I have one question that as for me, I'm not that much active in Quora. Means I'm more in B2C and LinkedIn and that kind of platform. But I think so in Quora, we can target depending on the hashtag and audio on some pages are like that. Page and hashtag is there or something?
No.
Where we can see the questions and answer over there?
No. Generally people according to their requirement people type questions also, and the most search questions, like there are many people who write for a particular question, so the most relevant one will be on top, and based on the views you can find hashtags. If you are putting hashtags, some questions you can get, but mainly people type questions and they get the answers.
Mm-hmm. Okay, the most voted audience you're telling.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm not seeing any enough questions today. I don't know what is happening today's webinar. Only 3-4 questions is there. Most of them are for LinkedIn and B2B content only. So do you want to answer anything related to B2B questions and how to strategize or something? It's because the queries are most of B2B.
Mainly I have explained most of the things in the PPT. B2B, as I told you, that LinkedIn is the best platform for B2B businesses, and for B2C, you can focus on Facebook, Twitter, in the PPT also I told you that video is the most it works much more better than text. So video content, if you're focusing more on video content, even for LinkedIn, then it will help to bring much more traffic for your brand.
Okay. Yeah. So I think so we have covered the questions what attendees have asked, and I have this question which you have answered also. So yeah, I think so we are done. That was a quick webinar we planned for content, how to, because it is more of a non-technical side, I think so. Non-technical side you can say, and it's more of writing and skilling yourself in that manner. So we have previous webinar links where we have talked about marketing automation, how to lead, how to generate lead and nurture them, how to do lead scoring, lead grading, scaling them and grading them. So that is all about what we have talked earlier in the episode number 1, 2, and 3. It was more of technical side. This was a little of the technical and how to write the content, how to publish it, how to strategize it. It was all about. that. But if you guys, if you want to see the webinar recordings, it's there in our YouTube channel. You can also see in a LinkedIn page of Aratech, and you can follow us over there in YouTube, LinkedIn. And yeah, so recording of the webinar, if you want the recording of this webinar, and we will be sharing the recording as well as the PPT with you guys. And that's it of the webinar. Thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for listening and taking out time for us and listening. This half an hour was very, I think so for me, it was very productive, and I have learned some basic concept of how to write and strategize that thing, the content, the blog, and all that, right? Okay, then. See you then next week with more exciting topics and with more. We are also inviting the guest speakers in upcoming months. We are having a lot more planning going on, where we will be going to a proper event kind of, where 3-4 our speakers will be there and asking questions. And so Gayatri is saying that I still have a question. Gayatri, can you please type it again so that we can see here in the chat box? I think so. It's there in the Q&A. I got the question. It's timestamp is important for posting. Are you saying about the scheduling? So I think so, Riya, she is talking about scheduling. Time scheduling is important for the scheduling, yeah. Posting the article or not.
Time posting article, I won't say, but yeah, time is a very important factor for posting on the social media platforms. So you have to analyze which time is suitable for your brand and what is your target audience, and accordingly you can post. Days are also there, relevant days are also there. So you have to evaluate your old content and old posting. Accordingly, you can understand which time and which days are best for posting.
Yeah, correct. I think so, Riya, this audience is also matter, and what kind of product you are having. If talking about B2B, it's more of having daytime after 10 o'clock and in the evening time. It's that
It depends on the brand and audience, what type of audiences you are targeting. If you are targeting dentists, then they are mostly free at the lunchtime. 1 to 4 is the best time for posting.
Means that time they will be browsing instead of because they will be not seeing patients and free.
Yeah, they will be free because night time also they will be busy with their cases or not cases for further studies. They will be busy or some other any other case studies. They will be busy. So lunch time is the best time for them.
So any other question you guys want to ask to Riya, we will be happy to answer that. Hope Gayatri, you got an answer what you're looking for. Hope she has answered it. And so I was talking about the May month. We have a lot of plans coming, events coming up in upcoming months, and we have some guest speakers also who will be coming here in our webinar and speaking about more topics related to marketing automation, and how to all the strategy means how to use all the features you can see in different automation softwares. They will be talking about that. And so we will be keep posting you in various pages. We have our LinkedIn page, YouTube page, Facebook page. Go and follow us so that you don't miss the opportunity or notification of the webinar. So guys, thank you for coming again. And you can see the recording. I will be posting it in the YouTube. Thank you again. Thank you, Riya, for joining.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.